There's a reason David Johnson is talked about as a first-round NBA draft prospect. Not only does he have great size at 6'5" for a guard, and he has great floor vision, something that he has developed through instinct and feel over the years, but he also has a great arsenal of passing delivery options. You see here, he's really good at the advanced pass, great outlet passing. He's an excellent finder of teammates who are already going to be in good scoring positions and putting them in a spot where they can think only about the defender in front of them and what they have to do to score the basketball. They don't have to worry about catching it cleanly. They don't have to worry about the delivery. You can see here, this is another great example where his ability to drive and score, he is understood now that that is going to attract attention of defenses, and in this case, all five defenders for Evansville. And this is where that ability to make an array of different types of passes helps him out. You see sort of a scoop, skip pass type to Sam Williamson. Kudos here to Jalen Withers. This is a great recognition of the situation that he can slip this screen and get into the lane, but this is what football analysts always talk about. Quarterback had to put the ball where only his receiver could get it. And in this situation, David Johnson has to put the ball in a good spot to lead Jalen Withers to the block and for a layup or dunk. That's exactly what he does. And he does it in a way that not only leads him in that direction, but it also is easy for him to catch. That's something that's so important for big guys. They need to focus on what's happening around them and not catching the pass. That's typically what ends up being a turnover or a missed layup. Jalen Withers does exactly that off a fantastic pass from David Johnson. This is a great example also of how smart Johnson is as a player. That's another thing that's sort of innate and has been developed over the years as he has continued to grow as a player. He recognizes the spacing on the floor and stops his momentum so that he can balance things out. Then he sells a potential pass over to Jalen Withers, which was something he probably had already thought about before the ball even arrived. Now, a narrow channel has developed for JJ Traynor underneath the basket, and this is, again, where the perfect pass has to be made, and it's made with good pace, and it's made in a catchable way for JJ Traynor, who shows good hands to collect the pass cleanly and go up and finish. Again, this is what sets David Johnson apart from a lot of other players as an assist guy. Unfortunately for Johnson, so far this season, he does have 29 turnovers against those 30 assists. That's too many turnovers. What I found is 14 of those 30 turnovers could have easily been averted had he not rushed through his decision-making process. I think something that's really interesting about David Johnson, I really truly believe from watching him play, he sees things developing faster than they actually develop. He sees things that his teammates don't see and that opponents don't see. And as a result, I think sometimes he throws passes people might not be ready for, or he thinks too quickly through the situation and the pass comes when it's not the right time, either a split second too late or a split second too early. In this situation, he's got Sam Williamson ready for a lob of some kind, and he instead throws a sort of half lob, half chest pass, and does not acknowledge basically the athleticism level that you would expect in an ACC game is going to be a little bit different than some of the non-conference games that Louisville played, and the pass is easily picked off. This is another situation, and there's a couple of these screenshots that I'm going to show you, where he rushes his decision-making after the initial move shows that he might be able to get into a scoring or creating position. You can see all the space in the lane there, and that first step is successful, but the defense closes on him, and instead of acknowledging the help defense and making a split-second decision with some patience and maybe backing out or passing out of it, he tries to dribble through trouble and turns it over. Something else that I think that's really important for David Johnson going forward, and something that I think he'll learn to grow into, is he's got to be able to accept when things are above average or good passes versus great or perfect passes. This situation and the screenshot after this are both examples of times against Pittsburgh when he waited to make what he thought would be the perfect pass, and by doing that, he dribbled himself into more trouble. Instead of delivering the pass here when it's available, he takes another step into that traffic and has the ball knocked away from his hands. It's hard for someone who is such an elite passer and such a great playmaker already at a young age into his college career to accept that some passes are not going to be as perfect as the others. He still has shown a few other times throughout the season that he's capable of thinking through those situations and not making that extra move that puts him into trouble. But the amount of times that he has done it is why he's still up at 29 turnovers to 30 assists. The bottom line is, though, if he can put together the patience needed to make good decisions, it's really going to help him here. This is a great example, back-to-back clips from the Kentucky game, back-to-back plays. One here is, in fairness, his teammates abandon him, and when the trap is arriving, they should probably have acknowledged this a little bit sooner and gotten back to give him more options in the backcourt. But as a ball handler and someone who should totally expect to be trapped and pressed a little bit more, this is where the decision needs to be made for David Johnson. But because his teammates have not come to help him out, and because he didn't quite get to his decision-making process for another step later, he puts himself in a really tough spot. Probably would have called a timeout here if it were me, but again, there's a reason why I'm sitting behind this computer and he's here. So, in future situations where Johnson can make a difference with his turnovers is if he does make that decision and see things develop a little bit slower for himself to calm his brain down and really think through each situation. Now, the alternative that we're about to see, as you see the turnover there and Devin Askew finishes for Kentucky, is exactly why David Johnson is such a good college player and has so much potential for the future. Both his recognition of situations when it is working well is something that really sets him apart, and then his ability to post up because he is that big guard, and then last but not least is the pass delivery. This is a great show of his patience and what it looks like when he is patient. He acknowledged after catching the pass that he could drive. He had a bigger man on him, so he went down into the post and thought about it as potentially trying to post up and flip a hook shot in, which he has done before. But instead, what he does is he sells the up fake. Now, in this exact moment, acknowledges that Kentucky's defense has completely collapsed around him. All five players are either in the lane or almost in the lane, and Johnson does a great job of both recognizing that Carlique Jones here right on the tail feather of the Cardinal Bird is open and is going to step into a three, but also he delivers the right pass through the traffic in the lane, and that is what makes David Johnson such an elite guard at this level and gives him so much more potential to be a big-time assist guy going forward for the Cardinals.